Y'all come close so
we can. We can't hear you.
I'm Andrew Daniel.
I'm Adam Daniel.
I'm Amanda Daniel.
And we're from Hot Top County, Oklahoma. Today in America, we have a lot of very flavorful foods. We enjoy processed meats, ramen noodles, spaghetti sauces, and potato chips. But the thing about all of these high flavor foods is that they are very, very high in salt and sodium. That's how they get their flavor. And too much sodium is not good for you. It can lead to hypertension, which is high blood pressure, and other heart and kidney problems. So today, we have tried to make a dish with as much flavor as we could using the most moderate amount of high sodium ingredients. So today, we worked with some bacon and chicken broth, but we tried to use moderate amounts of those. We tried to focus more on filling the dish with vegetables so that it will fill you with your hunger without loading you up on salt and sodium. We prepared this dish by first cutting our bacon and then cooking it on the skillet. Then we prepared and combined our vegetables in the bowl. Then we combined our chicken broth, our flour, our milk, our corn, and our cream corn in another bowl. After the bacon was done cooking, we sauteed the vegetables in a saucepan and then added the liquid mixture. When we were preparing the vegetables and the bacon, we made sure that we used separate knives and cutting boards and made sure that the bacon was cooked before adding it to the other ingredients to prevent cross-contamination. And when we used knives, we were sure to use proper cutting boards so that we could be safe.
Well, nutritionists are always telling us to make sure we can taste every color. That doesn't mean we can just fill up, fill up on a bunch of them and then. So we have to also make sure that it's full of nutrition dense variety. That's why dietitians teamed up with the USDA
since I've been born, the average cost for feeding a student my age, which is 16 to 18, has gone up about 62% according to the USDA. However, the minimum wage in that time has only gone up around 52%. So, we did our best to make sure that this meal is not only very healthy, but also cost effective. After adding together all the prices, the total cost for this meal was $2.42 for an easy chunky. Also according to the USDA, the average cost to feed someone 16 to 18 is about $3.60 per meal. So we've managed to save a bit of money by putting together what we have, and you could use that extra cash to go buy a banana or an apple, or to get some
fill the rest of the plate.
Yeah. And we do our best, especially we're from a family of six kids, so we know how important it is to work on stretching a dollar when it comes to food.
Do you have any questions?
Yes. How much, so the $2, and how much does it cost per serving?
The cost per serving.
Yeah, the cost per serving is one serving.
Okay, so this is one serving?
Yes.
So what, this would be equal to what? I mean, how much? How many ounces? How many cups?
I would say that there is probably 1.5 cups of vegetables in this,
okay,
along with maybe half an ounce of protein or maybe an ounce. Like I said, it's not completely full, but
yes, especially if you replaced the bacon with a leaner meat like chicken, you could have more protein without having to worry as much about the sodium.